welcome. You're watching our election special show, State of War. Over the next half hour, me and my colleague Akshita will take you through the one big common factor in these upcoming elections, dinners and their politics.
From Stalin and Son to Mamta and Bhanja, from the Gandhis in Top Gear to the BJP's own Parivarvad, this election season, India is once again asking, is this democracy or dynasticracy?
Vanakkam, I'm Akshita Nandagopal, joining you from Karaikudi in Tamil Nadu. I've been tracking the elections very closely here in the state, and the one word that keeps coming up against the DMK is dynast politics. The reason being that Udayanidhi Stalin, MK Stalin's son, seems to be rising up in the party ranks. He's an actor turned politician, and this time he's also been given a ticket to fight from the important Chepauk constituency in Chennai. The AIADMK has used this to say that it's not sunrise, but sun, S-O-N rise in the party. And they're saying that it's not Dravida Munetra Karagam anymore, but Dynast Munetra Karagam.
One family with politics in their blood. For over 50 years, the Dravida Munnetra Karagam has been led by the Karunanidhis. Kalangnar Karunanidhi was the DMK chief from 1969. His demise in 2018 paved the way for heir apparent Stalin to take over. And now the next generation has also entered politics. Udayanidhi Stalin is being groomed to take over from Stalin, with Udayanidhi getting a ticket to contest from the Chepauk constituency. The DMK has been branded as the Dynasty Munnetra Karagam by the opposition.
Mitro, वैसे देखें तो 2G, 3G, 4G सारा आपके तमिलनाडु के अंदर है. कैसे? 2G मतलब मारन परिवार की दो पीढ़ियां, 3G मतलब करुणानिधि परिवार की तीन पीढ़ियां, और 4G मतलब गांधी परिवार की चार पीढ़ियां. सारा का सारा यहां तमिलनाडु में हमें मिलता है.
बोथ कांग्रेस एंड डीएमके आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम इंटरनल कॉन्ट्राडिक्शंस. बोथ पार्टीज हैव ट्राइड टू लॉन्च एंड रीलॉन्च द रिस्पेक्टिव फर्स्ट फैमिलीज, बट दे हैव नॉट गॉट सक्सेस. There is a continuous family drama there.
Chief Minister EPS has used Udayanidhi as a political tool to slam his rival Stalin in almost every single rally. But Udayanidhi Stalin has refuted the charge time and again on India Today.
It's not that easy to be in my shoes. You have to be in my shoes to know what I'm doing and how much of difficulty I'm going through.
Udayanidhi has had a successful stint as an actor-producer. So why choose politics when he was successful in films? Well, it seems to be the most natural choice for Udayanidhi. It's like we said, the entire Karunanidhi family has politics in their blood. Karunanidhi had three wives. His first wife was Padmavati. Second wife was Dayalu Ammal. And third wife Rajati Ammal. Karunanidhi's eldest son, M.K. Muthu, never entered politics, choosing films instead. Dayalu Ammal and Karunanidhi had four children, M.K. Alagiri, Stalin, Tamil Arasu, and Selvi. Alagiri and Stalin entered politics. Tamil Arasu and Selvi chose a life away from public service. And then there is Kannimari, who was the child of Karunanidhi and Rajati Ammal. And the latest generation in this family to take the pole plunge is Stalin's son, Udayanidhi. The DMK is run by this family. It's not just the Karunanidhis, but even the Marans. Dayanidhi and Kalanidhi Maran are Stalin's cousin and they hold huge clout in the party.
For dynastic politics.
Pot, a pot calling the kettle black. So two generations of Amit Shah in BCCI is okay. Amit Shah was there, now his son is Jay Shah is there. They should look at the back. I can go on and on and on. What is in the BJP MPs? So what is the Minister of State for Finance? Who is he? His father was the Chief Minister of Himachal. You should come and talk about the policies. The election manifesto, which is announced by my leader, come and find fault in it. You don't want to do that. So you want to try to find some of them because you know that it's a winning election manifesto and DMK is on the right track. So how do I defame it?
This dynasty rule in DMK has definitely put Stalin on the back foot. And he has had to defend himself time and again.
இப்போ நான் வந்து படிப்படியாக தான் நானாக வளர்ந்து வந்திருக்கிறேன் அது மாதிரி உதயநிதியை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் எப்படி மற்ற கட்சி தொடர்கள் கட்சியில் இருக்கக்கூடிய நிர்வாகிகள் படிப்படியாக வளர்ந்து வந்து இன்றைக்கி ஒரு நிலநிலைக்கு வந்திருக்கிறாங்களோ அது மாதிரி தான் அவர் வந்து என்னோட துறைமுக தொகுதியில் தலைவர் எலெக்ஷன் நிற்கும் போது சேப்பாக்க தொகுதியில் நிற்கும் போது நான் ஆயிரம் விளக்கு தொகுதியில் வேட்பாளர் நிற்கிற போது அப்போல்லாம் வந்து எலெக்ஷன் கேம்பெயினே பண்ணி பிரச்சாரம் பண்ணியிருக்கிறாரு அதுக்கப்புறம் பார்லிமெண்ட் எலெக்ஷன் அப்போ ஃபுல்லாக டூர் பண்ணியிருக்கிறாரு வரக்கூடிய எலெக்ஷனை கூட்டி என்னென்ன ஆயத்த பணிகள்லாம் பண்ணணுமோ அதுக்கும் பிரச்சாரம்லாம் அவர் பண்ணி விடியலை நோக்கி ஸ்டாலின் குரல் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு தலைப்பில் ஒரு பிரச்சாரம் வந்துகிட்டு இருக்கு அதுலேயும் அவர் கலந்துகிட்டு இருக்கிறாரு இப்போ இளைஞரணி பொறுப்பு வந்தது பிறகு கம்ப்ளீட்டாக இளைஞரணியை ஒரு புத்துணர்ச்சியை ஏற்படுத்தக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு அது பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கிறாரு யார் வளர்ந்து வந்தாலும் இந்த கட்சியில் வந்து முக்கிய பொறுப்பு முக்கிய இடத்துக்கு வரக்கூடிய வாய்ப்பு நிச்சயம் உண்டு அப்படி தான் வந்திருக்கிறாங்க அப்படி தான் இருக்கும்
The flip side of one family calling the shots, there is enormous pressure to prove their mettle and a loss in the current circumstances will prove to be a death blow for the Karunanidhi heir Stalin.
So it is more a political battle than an ideological battle today, which it used to be till Karunanidhi was in the scene. So actually the media is not really noticing it. This is really a surprise for me because the leaders used to shift public opinion even on a small matter in favor of the parties which they represent. Today, there is no leader of that kind. Of course, both are good leaders for their own parties, but nothing beyond that.
But is it only the DMK that's guilty of nepotism? Well, the AIADMK also has a record of sunrise. O. Paneerselvam has been accused time and again of propping up his son, Ravindranath, within the party. Ravindranath is currently an MP representing the Theni constituency.
அவனா வேண்டுமானால் இந்த அரசியல் வாரிசுன்னு சொல்லிட்டு இருக்கு அதிமுக வேண்டுமானால் ஓ பன்னீர்செல்வத்தினுடைய மகன் அதே மாதிரி மற்ற அமைச்சருடைய மகன்கள் ஜெயக்குமாருடைய மகன் அவங்க தான் வந்து எந்த பணியும் இல்லாமல் நேரடியாக வந்ததுக்கு வாரிசு அடையாளமாக தெரியுறாங்கிறத தவிர திமுக பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் அது நடக்கவே நடக்காது
Dynasty has become one of the most talked about issues this election in Tamil Nadu. With both Dravidian parties trading words over nepotism. But will it be an issue that voters consider? The answer perhaps lies in Udayanidhi's performance in the Chepauk constituency.
West Bengal is not a state you usually associate with dynasty politics. Well, not up until now. The rise of the Pishi-Bhaipo duo, as their critics call them, has not only sealed the arrival of Trinamool's Gen Next. With this election, Abhishek Banerjee has also cemented his authority within the party, an undeniable fact that has ruffled many feathers. Here's a report.
মানুষের হৃদয় থেকে মমতা বন্দ্যোপাধ্যায়কে সরানো যাবে না আগামী 50 বছর বাংলার মাটিতে তৃণমূল কংগ্রেস থাকবে
Abhishek Banerjee. If after Mamata Banerjee, there is any one name the BJP is attacking for good measure this assembly election in Bengal, it is that of the Bhaipo or nephew. ২০২১ will go down as the year that saw the rise of the leader called Abhishek Banerjee.
তুম রাস্তে সে ফটো হটা সকতে হো, তুম ফ্ল্যাগ মিটা সকতে হো, তো এমএলএ কো তোড় কে লে জা সকতে হো, লেকিন দিদি কো জনতা কে দিল সে কেসে নিকালোগে?
Win or lose, the Trinamool Congress has found its heir apparent. The 33-year-old nephew of West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee is only a decade old in politics. But his will is now writ large over the party. Abhishek is the son of Mamata's older brother, Amit Banerjee. Abhishek joined the party in 2011, after it created history by overthrowing the 34-year-old left-front government. He had just returned from Delhi with an MBA degree from the now-defunct Indian Institute of Planning and Management. To the surprise of many, Mamata Banerjee created a new platform called Yuva for Abhishek to head. This despite a robust All India Trinamool Youth Wing being in place already, led by then TMC loyalist and now BJP leader Shuvendu Adhikari. Shuvendu, in his new avatar, has lost no opportunity to attack Abhishek. Many say he left the party in 2020 in protest against the nephew's rise, who he considers a product of nepotism.
ये तृणमूल कांग्रेस एक प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी थे परिणत हुए थे तार नेत्री एवं तार जे भाईपो एर बाहरे बाकी कारोरी को सम्मान नहीं मर्यादा नहीं अधिकार नहीं कथा बोलार जायगा नहीं सिद्धांते नीतिते अंशग्रहण करार सुजोग नहीं अर्थात बाकी सबाई लैंपोस्ट
Adhikari isn't the only one who quit over Abhishek's meteoric rise within TMC. It was Mukul Roy, Mamata's chief aide at one time, who hit the exit button first in 2017. While rattled by the Sarada Chitfund probe, Abhishek and his growing clout within the party's decision-making apparatus was also said to be one of the reasons. Mamata had been grooming her nephew for a while. In 2014, she made him contest the Lok Sabha elections from the safe seat of Diamond Harbour in South 24 Parganas. He won with a handsome margin, retaining it in the following election too. But it was in the year 2016 that Mamata started handing over serious responsibilities to Abhishek. In the run-up to the assembly polls that year, she made him in charge of districts like Nadia, Murshidabad, Purulia, North and South 24 Parganas. Abhishek even intervened when candidate selection caused some internal discord. Later that year, Abhishek met with a serious road accident while travelling from Murshidabad to Kolkata. As he spent 2 weeks in the hospital, the beeline formed by leaders and cadres alike to extend their good wishes left no doubt anymore to who was the TMC's next boss. As other TMC leaders found themselves entangled in the Sarada and Rose Valley chitfund scams or the Narada cash for favour sting, none of it touched the Banerjee scion. Allegations of corruption and tolabazi or extortion have been made several times.
बीते 10 सालों में कट कमीशन और तोलाबाजी कल्चर का सबसे बड़ा नुकसान बंगाल के गरीब बंगाल के दलित बंगाल के वंचित बंगाल के आदिवासी को ही हुआ है
बट फॉर ऑल दोज हु अलेज्ड अ डेफेमेशन नोटिस सून अराइव्ड एट देयर डोरस्टेप्स It was only in 2019 that Abhishek had his first direct brush with the law, when his wife, Rujira, was allegedly caught at Kolkata airport by customs carrying 2 kilograms of gold without any declaration. In a rare press conference, Abhishek refuted all charges.
Is it a crime to be associated with me? Does it signify you are Abhishek Banerjee's wife? That's why you were harassed and heckled. I challenge you, if you have the guts, come and arrest me. If you have the courage, Come and fight with me politically.
A Pandora's box had now been opened. and the BJP sharpened its attack against BIPO.
एक फैमिली पार्टी बनकर तृणमूल कांग्रेस रह गई है। 10 करोड़ बंगाल की जनता की चिंता करने बजाय मेरे भतीजे की चिंता करकर उसको एक बार मुख्यमंत्री बना देते हैं तो बहुत बड़ा बंगाल का उद्धार हो जाएगा। ये थियोरी पर जब राज्य की मुखिया चलती है तो इसी प्रकार के परिणाम आते हैं।
अभिषेक हेड बैक टू
এত ভয় এখন আবার আমার সাথে না লড়াই করে আমার বউকে টার্গেট করেছে কি বলছে আমার বউ নাকি 2 বছর আগে এয়ারপোর্টে সোনা নিয়ে ধরা পড়েছিল তো তোর CISF আর CBI কি নাকে নসি দিয়ে ঘোরাচ্ছিল যখন ধরা পড়েছিল
On February 23rd this year, CBI questioned Abhishek Banerjee's wife Rujira in a coal smuggling case. Rujira's sister Meneka Gambhir was also grilled. In a rare show of familial camaraderie, Mamata Banerjee went to Abhishek's residence the morning of questioning, stepping out with his young daughter before the CBI sleuths arrived. She was no longer going to sit quiet as her opponents attacked her nephew.
এতই যদি তোদের দিদি আর ভাতিজা বলতে হয় তাহলে আমি চ্যালেঞ্জ করছি অমিত শাহকে ফার্স্ট ইউ কন্টেস্ট উই অভিষেক ব্যানার্জি এন্ড টেল দ্য মেন আর কি কি করেছে তোমাকে বলতে হবে আর তা নাহলে মনে রাখবে তোমার ছেলেও কিন্তু এই করাপশনের চার্জ থেকে রেহাই পাবে না তোমার ছেলেকে তুমি লুকিয়ে রাখবে আর অন্যদের গালাগালি দেবে এটা চলতে পারে না
Abhishek's stamp over TMC is now visible to all, from the induction of election strategist Prashant Kishore to the drafting of the party's candidate list in 2021. The handover is near complete. The organization is run by BIPO now, claim his detractors. Mamata Banerjee is the face, they say. It is Abhishek who is running the show. The 2021 assembly elections are the acid test for this leader in waiting. With Palami Saha in Kolkata, Bureau Report, India Today.
Through India's political history, there have been over 30 families that have been active in politics. Here's a look back at India's dynasticocracy.
Till now, 17 times have the people of India elected their representatives to the Lok Sabha. While thousands of elections to local and state bodies keep fueling the robust political exercise that is the hallmark of Indian democracy. In the process, this vibrant mandate has thrown up political dispensations dictated either by the demands of the proletariat or by the charisma of an elected autarch. Or by authority of a paterfamilias and the dynasty that he set in place. Politics is a profession, and like other professions, there are families where children have followed in the footsteps of their successful parents. To carve out a niche in the same field as that of their forebears. Big and influential, sometimes in power and sometimes out of it. These political families are to be found across the length and breadth of the country. This election season in Tamil Nadu, the odds are favoring the Karunanidhi family, say some experts. Stalin, the scion, is on the move. If DMK wins this election under his leadership, the issue of Stalin being a worthy successor to Karunanidhi will be laid to rest. But when the word dynasty is thrown about and privilege is alleged, the scion is forceful in his defense.
The MLA padaviya indanida MLA appdinu thooki kuduthilla makkal edathile poi ninna makkalude aadharavai petru adarku piragatha MLA vara mudiyum இதே மாதிரி தான் நான் வந்து அரசியலில் நுழைந்தப்போ நான் மேயராக பொறுப்புக்கு வந்தப்போ மேயராக கூட நியமிக்கப்படலை மக்களிடத்தில் போய் ஓட்டு வாங்கி வரணும்னு சொல்லி தான் அப்போ அந்த மேயராக நின்னேன் ஆக மக்களிடத்தில் செல்வாக்கு இருந்தால் தான் யாராக இருந்தாலும் அரசியலில் வர முடியுமே தவிர யாரும் வந்து திணிச்சிட முடியாது அந்த நிலையை திமுக இன்றைக்கு எடுக்க
Next door, northwards, in Andhra Pradesh, the once dominant influence of the NTR family has waned, with son-in-law Chandrababu out of favor with the people. But the stars of Jagan Mohan Reddy, son of the late YSR, is on the rise. With his party, the YSR Congress, having swept the recent municipal elections, the Reddy political dynasty fortunes has decisively trumped the NTR family for now. When one mentions dynasty in independent India, then more times than not, one is referring to the Nehru-Gandhis. Known the world over as the first family of Indian politics.
The royal dynasty hai.
जो परिवार खुद को भारत का भाग्य विधाता था समझता था.
Yet, political dynasties have their ups and downs. And now, in its fifth generation, the family science seems to be jumping from one political setback to another. If the Nehru-Gandhi name has remained synonymous with just one party, there are old political dynasties in India whose members have straddled diverse political ideologies and across regions as well. The Sindhias of Gwalior are a prime example of this type of a mixed political heritage. But with the third generation Sindhia now having jumped ship, the entire extended family is once again united under a single colour, painted saffron. Two powerful political families in the Hindi heartland are new compared to those in the Congress or even the BJP. Both Mulayam Singh Yadav and Lalu are the products of the socialist upheaval of the 1970s. Ironic that both established political parties that not only propelled them to power, but turned their enterprise into family-run affairs. Currently, with both the families out of power, the business of politics is not yielding much electoral profit for these dynasties. One political family whose recent balance sheet can be said to be in the green is that of the Thackerays of Maharashtra. Built on identity politics, it is the moderate line that is currently dominant. The hardline faction, led by the nephew, having split the party of the Maratha Manus. The other powerful political family in Maharashtra is that of the Pawars, with patriarch Sharad Pawar still pulling a considerable punch both in the state and central politics. In Punjab, it is often mentioned that there are but five families who run the business of the state and almost all business in the state. Of them, the Badals, till not so long ago, was at the center of power both in Punjab as well as at the center. The controversial new farm laws seem to have hurt the politics of the Badal dynasty. But having quickly course-corrected, the family has once again aligned with the sentiment in their state. Sentiment is a powerful motive when it comes to establishing political legacy. The Abdullahs of Kashmir, despite being defeated at the ballot, can never be written off. And sentiment has played a role in aligning them with their political foes, the Mufti family. The fortune of Jammu and Kashmir, now relegated to being a union territory, has brought the two big political dynasties of the erstwhile state to share the same platform of combined dissent.
People's Alliance for Gupkar Declaration.
And the Gupkar Declaration is centered around 5th August 2019.
Patriarchs and matriarchs of powerful political families have become prime ministers of the country. And it is not just the Nehru-Gandhis who have done it. Haradanhalli, Doddegowda, Devegowda emerged from regional politics and became prime minister.
He and his family continue to dominate a sizable chunk of the politics in home state Karnataka. One of his sons, H.D. Kumaraswamy, has been chief minister multiple times. The current chief minister of Karnataka, too, has his sons joining his profession. His elder son, B.Y. Raghavendra, is a BJP Lok Sabha MP, while his younger son, B.Y. Vijayendra, is a BJP state vice president of importance. Haryana strongman Devi Lal used his political clout to become the deputy prime minister of India. The post filled after almost a decade to win over his allegiance at one of the most turbulent times of government formation in Delhi. Devi Lal's progeny represent the Jat vote bank in the state. His great-grandson, Dushyant, now plays a crucial role in propping up the BJP-led government in Haryana. Not just the Chautalas, Haryana is replete with political dynasties. There are the Hoodas, the Jindals, and the Lals, generations of families who are full-time politicians. From Jharkhand to Meghalaya, from Delhi to Kanyakumari, cutting across parties and ideologies, there are immensely powerful political dynasties active across almost every state and region of India. These are families whose profession is politics. Sons and daughters and extended relations, they live and earn their living out of politics. When they pass away, they make space for the next generation to take over. Because keeping it within the family is a tradition that political dynasties get made out of.
And that's all we have time for in this special broadcast on India Today. Thank you very much for watching. And remember to stay tuned to India Today as we get you the best coverage from the ground and the best analysis on the upcoming state elections.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.